This statement is false. Other forms of this classic paradox include, I am always a liar, everything I say is false, and if you're Pinocchio, my nose will grow longer. Now, this paradox has been tricking philosophers, mathematicians, and artificial life forms alike since the time of the ancient Greeks. But just how do we resolve it? Well, to start, the heart of the paradox is in its self-reference. That is, the statement describes itself, and in doing so, creates a contradiction. If the statement is true, it's false, and if it's false, it's true. One common solution proposes a third option, that the statement is neither true nor false. This is helpful because the statement doesn't just automatically become true if it's not false and vice versa. There are three options now, and so we're done, right? Well, not exactly. We could always reword the statement to say, this statement is not true, and we now have two categories again, true versus not true. And we're pretty much back where we started, except with a different version of the same paradox. A slightly more interesting approach would be to say that the statement is both true and false. But this goes against our intuition that contradiction should be avoided. In fact, the main drawback to this method is that it requires you to ignore the awesomely named principle of explosion. Now, this principle essentially states that when one contradiction exists, anything else can be proven true, creating an unusable system of logic, but that's a video for another time. Perhaps the most moderate response is that there are more than two or even three categories of truth. Using fuzzy logic, there can be a sort of scale of truth, ranging from 0 to 1, and so the liar paradox could range somewhere in between. And this interpretation is actually pretty useful in real life. For instance, saying this glass is full is not true, but it's not completely false either. It's somewhere in the middle, half full, or half empty for all you pessimists. Likewise, saying this statement is false may have some truth to it, without being on either end. So true, false, both, neither, or somewhere in the middle, the answer is not very clear, but it's still interesting that so few words can cause so much confusion. For some extra brain-bending goodness, consider contingent liars, statements like, I am wearing purple, and this statement is not true. The same approaches mentioned in this video apply, but now whether or not a paradox occurs depends on, well, whether or not you're wearing purple. Let me know what you think changes here, and share any variations you find in the comments below.